Tonight, how would you feel if someone at your child's school carried a gun?
Florida lawmakers are considering a proposed new bill that would allow some school employees to have firearms.
That bill has now been withdrawn from consideration by a Senate committee after last week's school shooting in Parkland caused some major pushback.
However, the bill is still sitting in the Senate and could move forward. In tonight's Insider's Report, WTXL ABC 27's Ashley Richmond takes a look at both sides of the issue and why you need to be aware of what's going on.
School shootings are terrifying, devastating, and now more common than ever in the United States. A group that keeps track of school shootings says since 2013, there have been at least 290, an average of almost one school shooting a week. This issue is hitting home for folks in Florida after a 19-year-old shot and killed 17 people in Parkland. That fear has students, parents, school employees, and lawmakers desperate for solutions, no matter how controversial they appear.
I just saw so many terrified children screaming and running from the building.
Teachers, students, faculty, and families in disbelief and horror as gunshots rang out through Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School on Wednesday, February 14th, 2018.
Jamie took a bullet and is dead. I don't know what I do next.
I just saw my daughter, cold as can be. She is gone.
When it comes to school shootings, actual solutions have been hard to come by. Now, people throughout the U.S., including the students from Stoneman Douglas, are demanding change.
Children died. Like, it doesn't matter what side of the gun control argument you're on, like, people are dead.
There's much more that can be done, much more that needs to be done, and much more that people like Marco Rubio and Rick Scott are not doing.
One lawmaker who is doing something, Florida State Senator Dennis Maxley.
This could be the difference between whether we have an incident or we have a massacre.
The Republican lawmaker sponsors Senate Bill 1236, simply called School Safety. Right now, it's illegal to carry a gun on school property in Florida. This bill would allow school officials to let trained armed volunteers, like teachers, bring their concealed carry weapons into the classroom.
It seems unfair to me that we ask school administrators and teachers to be responsible for the safety of our children, but yet we totally eliminate any opportunity for there to be an armed response to an armed intruder.
Being responsible means not letting just anyone bring a gun into a school. Under this bill, employees would have to get approval from the principal or district superintendent before carrying a gun on campus. Senator Baxley believes having guns in classrooms could stop a violent situation sooner.
And there's always a time delay, particularly as you get to more rural schools. It might be 45 minutes before someone could actually be there to help you. And what we find with studying these permit holders is they don't shoot people. What they do is demonstrate to a violent person that they will resist, and they leave. And so we avoid a violent conflict.
The bill was scheduled to be heard by a Senate committee on Tuesday, February 20th, but was pulled the Friday before. Bills similar to SB 1236 have been filed in four other states, according to the Giffords Law Center to Prevent Gun Violence. The center's legal director, Laura Cutaletta, says the idea of a hero stopping a shooter sounds good in theory, but rarely works in real life.
The Department of Homeland Security and the FBI have advised that in an active shooter situation, untrained civilians should not engage the shooter. They tend to put themselves or others in more danger. In the past, civilians trying to respond to such events have missed and injured innocent bystanders.
18 states already allow adults to carry a loaded gun on school grounds with certain permissions. It's not just about safety, it's also about cost. Senator Baxley says arming teachers that are already on the payroll is cheaper than hiring special armed guards. Cutaletto worries it's not as effective.
When you're a law enforcement professional, you spend every day focusing on keeping the public safe. If you're a teacher or, you know, a principal, your main job is something completely different. And so, you know, to arm them and expect them to be able to do the work of a law enforcement officer is not nonsensical.
We asked local school officials what they think about the bill. Gadsden County Schools Superintendent Roger Milton tells me he would not be comfortable with anyone except local law enforcement carrying a weapon on one of his campuses. He's worried that if a gun is not properly secured, it could fall into the wrong hands. We also asked parents what they thought about this issue. Dozens left comments on our Facebook page. Kimberly Bartlam wrote, "Why is this a debate? Armed guards should have already happened, and absolutely teachers should be able to protect our children and themselves." Rosewood says, in part, "Armed? No. What needs to happen is funding and talks against bullying, isolation, and hate."
If you look at the countries that do not experience the number of mass shootings that we do, they have very strict gun laws. The more guns that we have will not protect us.
Senator Baxley admits there's a long way to go before a bill like SB 1236 can pass. First, he says he's focusing on a bill that would let people concealed carry at churches and other places of worship. If that passes and goes well, he hopes it might ease some of the worry around letting guns on school campuses. If you have a story idea for the insiders, you can email us at abc27news@wtxl.tv. Attention, insiders. In studio, Ashley Richmond, WTXL ABC 27.